You can either be a legend or a dreamtime hero. Ziggy Stardust Lightning or as dead as a dodo. Let go.
Good evening. I'm Heidi Ferren here at the Pride of Britain Awards. We are here tonight for this extraordinary event co-sponsored by Kia to celebrate the true heroes and the true pride of Britain. It's an honor to be here, and I look forward to sharing our celebrity guests with you all throughout the evening. Here today at the Pride of Britain with one of our biggest celebrities, Jack McKay. How are you tonight, Jack?
Good.
Can you tell us a little bit about what makes you so special and why we're here honoring you among all the celebrities?
Well, I saved my little brother from a dog.
Your mother was carrying, right? It was a bull mastiff. Your mother was carrying your little brother and you saw the dog coming after them, and tell us what you felt at that moment. What made you run out in front of that bull mastiff?
Well, I didn't want to see Jacob get hurt, so I just ran at him.
Wow. Really remarkable. You are an example of true courage. Who taught you to be so courageous?
No one.
No one. And I have the incredible Renee Mae Bolter here to tell us a little bit about her courageous story. How are you tonight, Renee?
Okay, thank you.
Can you tell us a little bit about your extraordinary story?
My mom had a friend and he was decorating, and he got one of his friends to come over and decorate with us, and one night he switched and he held us hostage and he was hurting me and my mum, and I protected myself so she didn't get hurt, and I also hid the mobile phone so we could get out.
That is absolutely amazing. And you actually shielded your mother and your baby sister, isn't that right? You covered them with your own body to take the beatings, is that right?
I covered my sister, but my mom couldn't help us because he had his knee on her, so she couldn't get it.
You hid your mother's cell phone. How did you find the courage to keep hold of it that long? Where did you hide it?
I hid it in my trousers, so he couldn't get it, because he was asking for it.
I imagine you were pretty frightened at this time, is that right?
Yeah.
Wow. So where did you find the courage to go beyond your fear and save your whole family?
I don't know, because I love them.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Well, love can make you do some pretty amazing things, can't it? Wow. Well, you are a very courageous little girl, so I am honored to meet you tonight. And congratulations on your award. And I have the incredible Sissy Adamu here, who is one of the recipients of tonight's awards. Sissy, can you tell us what brings you here this evening?
Well, most of my life I've suffered illness, and recently I shaved my head for charity and raised money for the hospitals that have treated me all my life.
And you did that right before you were about to undergo radiation yourself, is that right?
Well, I had already had it, and I was told that my hair was going to fall out. So I thought that rather than letting it fall out, I'd shave it off.
And you have such beautiful hair.
Thank you.
Beautiful hair. Thank you. Yes. And you have your own blog, isn't that right?
Yes, I do.
Wow. Yeah. Well, I'm a fan. I'm actually on your blog. Oh, I've read it. I'm a fan. And I was really inspired by something that you said on it recently about your mission to put hope into the world. Yeah. Can you tell us a little bit about where that came from in you?
I just think one of the things that got me through being ill was definitely having hope. And I think that it's important in like today's big and bad world that you have a little bit of hope, because it can help you get through a lot of things.
Absolutely.
Even when I go, yeah, I go, like where the day. Choosing the pride of Britain?
It's really tough, really, really tough. There's lots of, arguing would be the wrong word, but there's lots of sort of debate about who should get an award. The difficulty is anybody that gets to the shortlist where we sit down and talk about them is worth a million awards.
Tonight's a night about courage, yes, and people that display extraordinary feats of courage.
Yes.
What to you is courage? What defines courage for you?
I think all of us face fears in life, and sometimes we run away from them, and sometimes we face them. And it's actually by facing your fears that enables you to grow as a person, and it enables you to become a better person and move forward in life. So I believe in facing your fear. I think that taking a leap of faith and taking a risk is what life is all about.
I actually just heard you chatting about Sissy. I was able to interview her earlier.
Oh, great. She's lovely.
Oh, she is. She's a big fan.
Oh, yeah. Well, it was great to meet her.
She told me earlier today that she had an opportunity to meet you, and she's been looking out for you. Do you think you'll get to catch up with her later?
I would love to meet her. Yeah, I can't wait. I'll look out for her. She's a great girl.
You seem all together. You're very well put together.
Really? Am I? Well, thank you very much. The corset I'm wearing.
Oh, really? Well, you were actually one of the judges for tonight's event, isn't that right? How was that for you?
It was really nice to be able to give a little bit back to everybody else, but I thought myself, everybody on the list that was nominated deserved an award, and so it was really tough to just pick one winner out of so many.
And in your life, who's inspired you?
Well, there's been loads of people that have inspired me. That's a pretty difficult question to answer. There's dozens of them, but I suppose for it all begins at home. So my dad was a great man, and you know we grew up on. I grew up not my son, but I grew up in Northern Ireland when there were some tremendous acts of bravery and courage by ordinary members of the general public.
tonight? Do you know of a story that inspires you?
I think I'll probably echo what most people have said, which is Stephen Sutton's story. You know, I think in the face of adversity and death, he showed so much courage and paved the way for people to... You know, his legacy financially means a lot of people will be helped, and just his bravery means people can face death possibly in a better way because he made that possible.
What inspires you to do the work you do? And I know you're involved in a lot of charity.
I wasn't very clever at school, and I love baking and cooking. And so I thought I'd train in that. And I've had a very interesting life. I'm enjoying every bit right at the moment.
You're looking very nice tonight.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I don't know what I'm wearing, but...
Yes.
I don't know.
It's all right. You can keep it on.
Okay.
So on a night celebrating courage and British courage, what do you think courage is? How do you define courage in your own life?
How do I find courage? Going against the things that sometimes people don't expect you to go against, you know, doing something different and being brave and willing to take risks. And I'm sure we're going to hear stories about people who've done things against adversity, probably what they shouldn't have done, and you know, have come through it.
What's the most special part of this evening for you?
Well, I'm giving an award tonight to a man that has changed my life. It's a doctor, a professor, that invented... Oh, I don't know if I'm allowed to say whose line am I.
Oh.
I don't know. Well, basically, it's a doctor that invented a drug that meant the difference between me restoring my eyesight. So, like, a very inspiring, amazing pioneer.
I have a present for you.
Oh my God, look at that, that is so thoughtful.
Kia takes care of you.
Thank you so much for that. I really needed a bag of these.
Hey, anything we can do for you? Are you excited about tonight?
Very excited, yeah. We like coming to these awards. But you know, like I said before, you've made my night.
Hey, it's my pleasure.
I'm quite a soft.
Are you?
Yeah, I cry a lot, you know.
Well, there's nothing wrong with that. There's no shame in a big heart.
You know when it hurts? Yeah.
We're going to be goodbye.
Yeah, it hurts. Really hurts.
Do you know anything about the awardees this evening? Is there a story that inspires you?
No, I mean, we're presenting an award tonight, and we got a little information on the girl that we're presenting an award to, and it just shows that it makes you realise how lucky you are in life. And you know, this girl is an absolute hero. So, and you'll see more about her tonight, what she's been through, not only once but twice, and still going through, and what she does for charity. And this girl, a young girl called Cece.
I interviewed her earlier today.
Oh, amazing. Okay, so I'm getting tingles talking about it. She's I can't wait to meet her. So.
But how would you define courage on this night celebrating courage? What do you think?
Putting other people in front of yourself, I suppose, isn't it?
Yes, it is. It is, and you do that.
And overcoming the typical parameters that define us, things like sort of selfishness, greed, and all that kind of stuff.
Is there anyone in your life in particular that has inspired you along the way?
Yeah, loads of people. Every day, like every day, I hang out with other people with drug and alcohol problems that help me stay clean. So it's sort of, and I think what's so good about tonight is it's an opportunity to think about the communal values that we all have rather than the glorification of the individual.
Yes, yes.
How
exactly.
About that for a sentence?
I like that. Tonight's a night of extraordinary people, courageous people. What do you think defines true courage?
You know, people with like a passion to keep going on and keep striving for that, you know, they won't stop. And I think that's what people, you know, they don't ask for any thanks, and they don't do it for like self-gratitude or anything like that. They just do it because they believe it's the right thing and help. And I think it's amazing. And I can't wait to cry, actually. Yes, because I always watch this program. So it's an honor to be here tonight to watch everyone. And, you know, so hi. Oh, Simon.
Very well. How are you? Yes, it is.
Kia Radio?
Kia, of sorts, yes. Okay. Kia Live. And talking to you. Congratulations on your new little one.
Thank you very much. He's adorable.
What is it that inspires you the most in your own life?
I like seeing people do well.
I'm British, I like British things we do to do well. I'm quite patriotic, so, you know, regular things.
You look incredible!
How are you, my love?
I'm very well.
Good.
I actually saw you recently. I was in the community choir singing behind you on Hallelujah at the event, wow. The World War One.
Oh my God!
Anyway,
so we took that group photo together.
We did,
yeah,
yes. You look beautiful.
Thank you, sweetheart.
It's a magical evening full of extraordinary people.
I know.
Are you ready for the tissues?
I'm never sure how ready I am for this kind of event because it's so touching, but you know what, it's a humbling experience. It's an absolute honour to be asked to even attend. And you know, it's not about anyone of us that are here on the red carpet, it's about those that we're honouring tonight. So I think tonight's going to be an extraordinary night.
May I interview you?
Only if you take your heels off.
No, I'm kidding,
No, this is how I stood in junior high, I'm used to it.
Really?
Yeah,
okay, I'll come up, no, yeah, there, yeah. Is that better?
Yes.
Give me your first name.
Heidi, my name is Heidi. Very nice to meet you. I sung with your brothers in Branson, Missouri.
Did you really?
When I was 12.
Really?
I did. You.
How was the experience?
It was incredible. Your whole family is incredible.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much.
Big inspiration to me and loads of other people.
Thank you.
So
you're living here in the UK now?
Yep, yeah. Back and forth.
Don't you love it here?
Oh my gosh, yes, it's incredible.
If I couldn't live in America, I'd live right here.
I know. This is where it all started, isn't it?
It is. It really is. I have. It's almost like coming home.
Yes.
I always say that when I come here, but I really mean it.
Well, you are coming here, are you not?
I am. Okay. I'm going to be here all week.
Yes.
I've got a lot of work this week. Yes.
Well, you are an inspiration to so many people. Who has inspired you along the way?
Well, musically or personally? What? Let's go musically. When I first heard My Sherry Amore by Stevie Wonder, I mean, that just did it to me. Mm-hmm. Obviously, you know, when I go back to my 5-year-old Andy Williams, he taught me how to sing, working with Henry Mancini and Dave Grusin and all those people. But then when Stevie came aboard, I tell you, he just changed my life. And it's such an honor to have him on my new album.
You look fabulous. You would never know that you've been running around all day.
I have just come from the Strictly rehearsals. So
you must be
6 hours.
Oh. How are you walking?
I'm not. I think I'm floating.
You are. I thought you were gliding up the red carpet. Well, I saw that.
Now we have to walk in a certain way, but yeah.
In a night of inspiring people, who has inspired you along the way?
Along the way, in my life.
In your life.
It's got to be my mom. Oh. That's it. That's the, you know, single mom raised me. You know, she worked 3 jobs. That's my hero.
Yeah. Thank you.
Put it in there.
Yeah, Kia. What?
Nice one.
What an extraordinary evening at the Pride of Britain Awards. I have had the opportunity to speak with some amazing people, but the most special part is celebrating all of the people that are unsung heroes. And tonight is about them. This is Heidi Ferren with the Pride of Britain.